It's crazy to think that I'm standing here tonight introducing Bailey, when a year ago I was quizzing her on how many dairy cows the state of Nevada has for her officer test. Having Bailey as a best friend is a lot what I imagine being married would be like. We laugh at things only we can understand, we argue, we sometimes even get into physical slap fights, which if we were actually married would probably be classified as abuse. And sometimes I even come home to a cooked meal or a failed attempt at spaghetti. There's 100 stories I could tell you, some of which are better left unsaid because our moms are here. But there's one moment in particular I'd like to share. It was our senior year semi-final soccer game. Our whole season had led up to this game. Hours of practice, Bailey overcoming a knee injury, and the simple fact that it had not been the best year of Douglas soccer, starting over with a new team, mostly underclassmen. But that game, Bailey and I gave it our all, knowing it could be our final moments playing soccer for the rest of our lives. A sport we loved so much, and that was the core of our friendship. In the last moment, we had lost by a free kick from Lincoln. Our entire team was at a loss of words. Bailey and I found each other in the middle of the field and broke down crying in each other's arms. In that moment, I knew there was no one else I wanted to end this chapter of life and start the next with. She would not only be the arms to embrace me in our final, in our last moment of our soccer careers, but during my multiple college breakdowns, during the heartbreak I thought I would never get over, during the moments of celebration such as tonight, and sometimes when I just need a hug. I am honored to have such a kind, hardworking, and often very forgetful person as my best friend and the sister I never had. I am so incredibly proud of you, Bailey, for everything you've accomplished, and I can't wait to see what the future has in store for you.
Bailey, AKA my big sister, is retired from FFA state secretary position. She has moved me along with many 4-H'ers and FFA students by teaching us the importance of raising healthy market animals. Bailey has encouraged me to give 4-H a try. She has helped me with many experiences, even if it means being a big sister. I have always admired her and all her work, striving to reach the next goal. Whether it be her job, FFA, school, or working with her animals, she has taken time to work with others, teach the importance of FFA. She has taught me life lessons, making it fun and enjoyable. A time I remember spending with her was when we had a plan to camp at Bull Lakes in a tent next to our parents' travel trailer. We wanted to pack our own food, prepare our own meals, and sleep in our own tent. We even went as far as buying our own camping supplies from the dollar store in Walmart. Stay within budget. Little did we know, after having to pack our food, tent sleeping bags, clothes, etc., into Bailey's little blue car named Dory, that we both had a lot to learn about preparing ourselves for such an adventure. After struggling with finding all the parts into our tent and finally putting it up, we could smell the yummy steaks our parents were barbecuing across the crossroads. While we were eating our dollar store Lunchable dinner, we both looked at each other and thought, what the heck are we doing? We could be eating steak instead of this. But still, wanted to show our parents that we could do this without their help. Little did we know, about midnight, we caved in and decided to knock on the trailer door, begging to come in where it was nice, warm, and cozy. Well, what can I say? We tried. I have seen her come a long way in her life, and to see her successes makes me realize how lucky I am to be her sister. Thank you, Bailey, for all your support.
I've been kind of living in memory lane, going through phenomenal. I've learned a lot about the officers that are coming. And I was thinking during ours, I remember how I became an FFA member. And I remember the first time I put on my FFA jacket. I remember I came to school and everything but the jacket. And at lunch, I put it on, because after lunch, I got to present the FFA crate. And I was chosen to represent the Carson Valley FFA at state last year for grade speaking. And I would not have done as well as I did without Bailey Christensen. And looking back on my agricultural careers and who I am today, it really came down to two people. And Bailey is one of those people that has given me a push. She saw something within me and inspired me to become the FFA member I am today. And I don't think I'd be up here being able to give a speech without Bailey. If it wasn't for her coaching me in the FFA grade, I would not be a part of speech and debate. I would not be an active FFA member. I don't even know if I'd be an FFA officer. And I just want to thank Bailey for all that she's done for me. Without further ado, for 2017-2018, Nevada FFA State Secretary.
Okay, here it is. I love Hannah Montana. When I found out that
And I even went to a live concert in 3D at the Galaxy Theater when I was just 12 years old. I loved her. But why? I love the idea that she had two personalities. She could be normal, but also have the life of a rock star. Isn't that awesome? I should have thought so. But it wasn't until I saw her movie that I understood the struggle of living two lives. In her movie, she sings a song called The Climb, which I loved, but didn't understand its whole result. So, although it seems a little cheesy, what does this song actually mean? What was the message that Hannah Montana was trying to send? I think we all have a clue, but not quite an understanding. And it took me up until this year to understand what The Climb means. Let's take a look at these lyrics. Usually it's not. places that are hard to reach. And that is life. But does that stop us from trying? I implore you to keep your head up and keep climbing. Even if you fall or change course, keep climbing. Even if you think you can't, you can. My personal climb took a few steps back with my soccer injury, but it led me to a new path. I became a state officer, and that's where I realized that my life belongs in agriculture. Little did I know that putting on this jacket would give me an instant family of about 2,000 Nevada FFA members. But it's not just a jacket, it's a cape. A cape that helped me to be more confident, loving, prideful, and disciplined. If there is anything that I want you to take away from this, it is to keep your head up and keep climbing. Look back on your struggles and realize how far you have come. Every mountaintop is within reach if you just keep climbing. And remember, just like Hannah Montana says, life's a climb, but the view is great. Yeah.
Thank you.